How bad you want it? Like when Bradley fought Provodnikov, nothing would have stopped him that night. He was knocked out on his feet and he kept fighting, throwing.
He was knocked out till the next day.
But he kept throwing.
He kept throwing. And like you said, nobody's going to take this from me. And he did.
What do you think, both of you guys, real quick? Manny Pacquiao, Chris Algieri.
Testing 1, 2.
I think, you know, right. Algieri is a very athletic fighter. He has great athletic ability, great boxing ability. But I just think that in boxing, if you don't have the power, if you don't have the power to stop your opponent, he's never going to stop coming. And Manny Pacquiao is a high-intensity fighter. That Danny, in order to know Manny Pacquiao, you got to be in the ring with him. And I already know him twice.
And that's okay.
I've been in the dressing room with that guy. Even when he's shadow boxing, you could hear that nice, that little whimp of his punches. And I think Algieri is going to put up a fight. He is. His athleticism is going to give him that edge to fight. But at one point in the fight, he's going to have to engage. And when he engages with Manny and he feels the power and speed, then things are going to change. Yes. I just feel like that he's going to go into a survival boxing mode. Yeah, in which either you have to hold or you have to move. And in order to move a man, you're going to have great conditioning. He has it, but can he withstand the speed, the angles, the footwork? That's what we're going to see.
What do you think, Jose?
I agree 100% here.
Your son sparred Manny, Jose. I was there for some of that.
Yeah, but sparring is sparring, I think, you know. But, you know, I'm going to have to go with Manny, you know. I think he's the more experienced guy. I think footwork, angles, and all that, I just got to go with Manny.
Robert Garcia told me it was harder to get ready for Manny than to get ready for Mayweather. Was Manny the hardest guy for you to get ready for, or did you have another opponent that was tougher for Tim?
No. Manny to this day, man, he's just another breed, honestly. Going into this training camp for Bradley, let me just tell you, a lot of people don't see it. You gotta live it. Bradley wanted to make some changes. Bradley wanted to make some changes in his nutrition. And he tells me, coach, and it says, coach, I just feel like, why? Because we started training like a month ago, just coming into the gym, working on the weight, you know, so we didn't have to go through issues. So then he goes, coach, I just feel like I'm draggy. Why? I changed my nutrition because he was going vegan.
Right, remember.
Every single one of his fights. And he always performed well. So I go, well, what are you changing? He goes, I'm changing a lot of things. Like what? He goes, I'm changing now. I'm eating meat. I'm eating this. I mean, I said, why? He goes, coach. He was, people tell me that, you know, the reason why I performed like this with Manny on this fight and then the first one is because I'm not eating the proper foods. I said, okay, when you fought Marquez, when you fought Provodnika, when you fought everybody else, how did you feel? I feel great. I go, why are you going to fix something that's not broken? First of all, let me tell you something. A lot of people are trying to dip their spoon in your plate. If you listen to everybody, you're going to be confused. If you have a question, come and ask me. I can answer your question. I'm the closest person to you. Ask me. And he goes, what do you think the problem was? I go, the problem is not your nutrition. The problem is not your training. The problem is the high intensity of opponent that you had in front of you. I mean, when you have a Manny Pacquiao in front of you, believe me, things change. Why? Because that guy keeps you on the tip of your toes. You know, Manny Pacquiao is a fighter that, you know, he's so intense at a high level that you don't know where he's at. I mean, I go, remember the first time when you fought me? He goes, yeah. What did you tell me when you got out of the ring and then we're at home? Didn't you say, coach, that guy throws so many punches? And I was like, oh, shit, you were moving? He says, what did you tell me? That you will hear like somebody was shooting bullets at you? Like, whoosh, you will hear? Okay, that's the high intensity that Manny Pacquiao brings. And the reason why is a high intensity fighter, it's at another level of stage that you're in. The spotlight is high. It's a high intensity. I said, your body just fatigued because of the intensity of the moment. And he goes, you're right. Go back to what you were doing. So look at him. He went back. He's vegan. He feels good. He, you know, he's not feeling draggy anymore. And because at this point of a fighter's career, everybody has an opinion. If you have 100 people in the room and you're there, everybody's going to give you a different opinion. And everybody's going to tell you, he's wrong.